It's the last part. We're going to let y equals h of x be the particular solution to the given differential equation with h of 0 is equal to 3. Use Euler's method, starting at x equals 0, with two steps of equal size to approximate h of 1. And if you're not familiar with Euler's method, hopefully you are, but they're basically saying if we were to solve this differential equation, which for our intents and purposes we don't know how to do, but if we could solve this and find some function h of x, you know, that graph would have some kind of shape, whatever it may be. And this differential equation is describing the slope of this function h, you know, basically everywhere that h is differentiable. And we're going to say, hey, we know that at the x-coordinate of 0, h is equal to 3. So we have this point of, and this doesn't match what's necessarily going on, but there's some point at 3. And we can't really truly know exactly what h of 1 is equal to because we don't really know what function h is. We can't solve this differential equation, but we can use tangent lines and say, hey, we're going to find this tangent line, this, you know, using the derivative, using the slope, at 0, 3, and we're going to make a small step, well, to this point of, if we're taking equal, two equal-sized steps between 0 and 1, each step is going to be 1 half, we're going to move over to the x value of 1 half and just find out where the tangent line is at that point, or at that x-coordinate of 1 half, and let the tangent line approximate the value of the actual function h. And then, at that point, we're going to go back to our differential equation, which is describing the slope of h, and find out, hey, okay, at the x value of 1 half, function h takes on this approximate y value. Now, while the y value is approximated, we have a function which is going to give us the slope. And so then we're going to analyze the slope at our estimated point, and then off of that, and we see our graph is dropping here, come up with another tangent line, and then step over to the x value of 1 and estimate again where is function h at 1 using this next tangent line that we found using the previous estimated point and the slope from the differential equation. That's what Euler's method is. It's just a sequence of tangent lines and approximations with those tangent lines to approximate some function given a differential equation and an initial point. So, little mini micro Euler's method lesson there. We don't need the second derivative anymore. Unless you wanted to analyze whether your linear approximation was an over or an underestimate. One step off. Okay, so at the point of 0, 3, what is our slope? Dy dx at 0, 3 is equal to 3 times 0 minus 1/3 our y-coordinate. And this first part was made out to be relatively neat. We have our slope is equal to negative 1. Now, you can abbreviate and kind of streamline this notation a little bit. Sometimes your textbook asks you to do a ridiculous amount of steps. Sometimes my textbook that I teach from had them do like 10, 15, 20 steps, so monotonous, of Euler's method, but we're only doing two here. So I'm not going to worry about having this two streamlined. I'm going to now use that tangent line. We have a point of 0, 3 and a slope of negative 1, and I'm just going to use like sort of like point-slope form. We have y minus the y-coordinate of the point, 3, is equal to negative 1 times. Now we're taking a basically a half step off of x equals 0. So it's going to be 1 half minus the x value of this point, which is 0. And if you're taking equal size steps, you don't really honestly need to do sort of like a x sub 1 minus x sub 2 or something like that. It's going to, should always work out to be a difference of 1 half, but you do need to do the y minus y sub 1 equals m times x minus x sub 1 and actually calculate that step if it changes through your Euler's approximation. So we have y is equal to negative 1 half plus 3 over 1. Find a common denominator, and we have y is equal to what? 5 halves. So now we're going to go to step 2, where we have an approximated point for function h using our tangent line. Our new point is a half step off, so it's 1 half and the new y-coordinate we just found of 5 halves. And while we have a point, we don't have a slope. Oh, by the way, is this a reasonable first step? Well, actually, I'm starting up my second step, but is this point a reasonable answer for the end of my first step? Well, off of the point of 0, 3, we did get a negative slope. So if we step to the right a half unit, we should expect our y value to shrink a little bit, and we did go from a y value of 3 to a y value of basically 2.5. So now we need to know what the slope of the tangent line is at this approximated point. So dy dx at 1 half 5 halves is equal to 3. Times 1 half squared minus 1 third times 5 halves. We're looking at 3 fourths minus 5 sixths. We need a common denominator, so we're going to multiply by 2. Well, I'm saying multiply by 2 and by 3, but 2 over 2 is 1 and 3 over 3 is 1. So we have what? 9 minus 10, so negative 1 over 12. Stepping off a half unit over to the right, we have that, and using the point slope form of a line, no reason to streamline this for only two steps, we have y minus y sub 1 is equal to m, negative 1 12. Times x, a half step to the right of 1 half is 1, minus, x sub 1. So we're looking at y is equal to 1 half minus, 1 minus 1 half is 1 half, times negative 1 12th is negative 1 24th, plus 5 over 2, multiply top and bottom by 2, 12, and we have y is equal to negative 1 plus 60, or 59 over 24. Thus, or therefore, based on these two steps of Euler's approximation, we have that h of 1 is approximately, this isn't exact, it's based off of tangent line approximations, 59 over 24. I'm Mr. True. Bam! Go do your homework.